this is my current trail bike, and I've actually been riding the same geometry since 2016. And in my line of work, that's a really long time. Now, truth be told, I actually love this bike. I love the geometry, it fits me great, I'm used to it, but it's time for something new. As you know, I was in a sponsorship with Diamondback, and so this was always their top of the line trail bike, and I had it when it was alloy, I had it in different color schemes, now I have it in carbon, I've had it with different components, but it's really the same bike when it comes to geometry. And today, that's gonna change. Welcome back to Berm Peak, I'm Seth, and today we're gonna be doing something a little bit different, but kind of the same. So some of you might be wondering, what sign is gonna go right here? Who is sponsoring the channel from this day forwards? And the answer is nobody. I'm not getting a bike sponsor, I'm not gonna get a component sponsor. I'm actually not interested in getting sponsors anywhere in the bike industry. Now that doesn't mean I won't enlist the help of companies to build bike parks or public projects. I will definitely let them sponsor that. I have friends in the industry who can send parts here. I'll be transparent with you about that. But I don't want a bike company contributing to my income. I'm gonna have to find different ways to do that. But why not? My experience with Diamondback was great. I think it was as perfect as a sponsorship arrangement could really get, but I'm in a very different place now. For one, I could definitely get by without that sponsorship. And creatively, I wanna just review all sorts of weird things. And some of them would fall into the category of semi-normal bikes, and I don't want there to be a conflict. I don't want to sort of push the boundaries of a sponsorship arrangement. I want to just be able to do whatever I want. And so with that, what's the story with my new bike? Well, the story is it's in this box and I gotta build it up, and it's from a friend. I have friends at Revel Bike Company, and they sent me the Revel Rail. Comes with I9 hubs. One of the things I love about this bike, first of all, comes with some parts that were made right here in Asheville, like the Industry 9 hubs, the Cane Creek headset. I'd say part of that is because one of Revel's founders has ties to Asheville. Now, Revel's in Colorado, and they've designed the frame and actually the wheels. And as you can see, the bike has 27.5-inch wheels. I promise you, I will get a 29er, but for my main trail bike, where I'm gonna be smashing jumps and testing sketchy features, going to bike parks, I wanted to stick with what I was used to. And this is a much bigger bike than I normally ride. And by bigger, I mean it has more travel. It's 170 millimeters in the front and 165 in the rear. This bike comes with pretty much everything that I would put on it in the first place, but we are gonna change out the drivetrain and the dropper post. So now that we took some ridiculously nice parts off this bike, you might be wondering what we're gonna put on it. Some of you probably already know. Yeah, going fully wireless. I wanted it to be special. I'm a nerd, I like wireless stuff, and like this is like the first real new bike I'm gonna have in 6 years. I wanna go all out. Ooh, that's nice. So still lots to do. I've gotta adjust the stack height, burn in the brakes, dial in the suspension. That's all stuff I'm gonna have to do over the course of a few days riding this thing. Right now, we can see how much it weighs. 32 pounds on the dot, that is 14.4 kilograms. That is pretty nice for a bike with such big suspension. I mean, look at those stanchions.
Oh man.
I think it's time to stare at it. Yeah, I'm gonna ride it around, see how it feels, and we'll make some adjustments, but I think I'm ready to start trying some stuff. Got a problem with the bike? Just started raining. I don't want this to be the end, and so I'm gonna try and hit this stuff. I don't think it's that sketchy in the rain. Had a quick downpour, soaked everything. There are certain wooden features here that I'm not interested in riding in the rain, but I would be interested in riding snake pit. It's amazing how little you feel when you land on this bike. Sometimes I like feeling stuff, that's why I ride my hardtail a lot, but this soaks up the trail big time. But I'm still able to pull up and throw it around and everything. It's still a size small, it's still 27.5, and I can still kind of tune the suspension how I like. I don't want to push my luck, but I think we can hit the whale tail.
Whoa!
Okay. The bike does not feel alien to me. I knew what the geometry was before I set foot on it, and I knew I would like it. But what really feels different is that I haven't had a bike with this much travel in such a long time. It's really linear compared to what I had my last fork set at, and when I dropped in, I wasn't expecting it to sink in so much for some reason, but I think I got it. All right. That is all I care to ride with everything this slick, but I'm liking this bike. It's gonna take a trail ride to really get the suspension dialed in. Either gonna do that tonight or this weekend, but let's go back to the shop and debrief. I can't believe this is my bike. Definitely the nicest bike I've ever had. I've gotta go on a trail ride to really get the suspension dialed in. I do wanna make a couple of changes. Wanna reduce the stack height. That's the amount of spacers between the head tube and the stem. I wanna reduce the volume in the fork very slightly. But otherwise, I don't want to change a damn thing. This bike feels good. That's not surprising at all. I knew exactly what the geometry was before I received it. I knew it was something that I would like. I'm really looking forward to all the things that I'm gonna be able to do with a little more travel and forgiveness. Anyway, I hope you're as excited as I am for this new bike. This is very different from anything else I've owned in the last 6 years. And I'm really interested to see how it performs at speed at a bike park. So thanks for tinkering with me in the shop today. I hope you learned something, and if not, I hope you at least found it entertaining. Thanks for riding with me today, and I'll see you next time. All right, it's Sunday evening. Gonna finally take this bike on its maiden voyage on a proper trail. Bike climbs really nice. Even with all this suspension travel, you're just kind of sitting on top of it when you're climbing. Yeah, we'll probably just be at the point where we need lights.
Yeah.
Okay, bike's feeling great. Dialed in the low speed compression a little bit. I'm gonna actually bring the bars in by about 20 millimeters, and then I'm gonna reduce the stack a little bit, and I think I'm gonna be perfect. I could get into trouble on this thing. Yeah, it's humid.
Made a mistake.
Might be a hornet's nest here too.
Yeah, I hear him. I'm gonna get the hell out of here. All right, guys, maiden voyage. I'd say it couldn't have gone any better than that. Oh, yeah. Yeah.